Hello, this is Boost Solutions. Welcome to our channel. Today, we are going to introduce how to set column permissions for a SharePoint online list. Please find the product page link and user guide in the description for following this video. Before diving into step-by-step operations, let's first get a general understanding of the overall column permission control that will be involved. In the column permission control, we primarily focus on managing column access in the following three scenarios. When users create a new item in the list, we ensure that certain columns are hidden during item creation. When users edit an existing item in the list, we ensure that certain columns are either hidden or set as read-only during item editing. When users browse a list in the list view, we ensure that certain columns are hidden from the list display. To achieve this, we apply permissions to specific users, controlling their access levels to the columns. Now, let's visually see the changes that will occur after configuring these three settings. Here, we set the column A as hidden in the new item form. As a result, when specified users try to create a new item, they won't be able to see this particular column in the new item form. When it comes to editing an item, we have the option to set a column as hidden or read-only. If we set column A as hidden in the edit item form, when specified users try to edit an item, they won't be able to see this particular column in the edit item form. If we set column A as read-only in the edit item form, when specified users try to edit an item, they will still be able to see the column A, but it will not be editable for them. At last, let's set column A as hidden in the view item form. As you can see, when specified users view the list, they won't be able to see the value of the column A in the list view. All right, it's time to dive into the column permission product and put these features into practice. Once you have successfully deployed the column permission app into your SharePoint online environment, you will notice the column permission button appearing on the list command bar. Here, in the list, we have the column A. It's a number type column. And the today function has been set as the default value. Since we haven't set any permission yet, if we try to create a new item now, the column A is visible in the new item form with the default value. Let's go to column permission to create our first permission setting. Click on column permission. And then click on add a permission part. Name it as hide column A when creating a new item. Then, specify a user to apply this permission setting to. Here, we specify Cecilia. In the Set Column Permissions section, select Hidden for the new item form of column A. Click Save. The permission part has been successfully created. You can edit or delete it whenever necessary, or simply toggle it on and off as needed. Now, when Cecilia tries to create a new item in the list, she won't be able to see column A in the new item form. The column is hidden and invisible to her. The permission part is effectively applied and working as intended. since we haven't set any permission for editing yet. If we attempt to edit the item now, the column A will be visible and editable. Let's proceed by creating another permission part. Click on Column Permission. Click on Add a Permission Part. Name it Hide Column A when editing an item. Specify Cecilia to apply this permission setting. In the Set Column Permissions section, select Hidden for the Edit Item form of Column A. Click Save. Now, when Cecilia attempts to edit the item, she won't see Column A in the Edit Item form. The column will remain hidden and inaccessible to her. Let's proceed to edit the permission setting we just created. Click on Column Permission. Then click Edit for the permission part. Change its name to Set Column A as read-only when editing an item. In the Set Column Permissions section, select Read Only for the Edit Item form. Click Save. Now, when users like Cecilia attempt to edit an item, they will still be able to view the content of Column A, but won't be able to make any modifications to its data. This ensures that the data in Column A remains protected and unalterable during the editing process. Let's proceed with creating another permission setting to control the visibility of Column A in the list view. Click on Column Permission. Then click on Add a Permission Part. Name it Hide Column A in List View. Specify Cecilia to apply this permission setting. In the Set Column Permissions section, select Hidden for the View Item form of Column A. Click Save. With this new permission part in place, when Cecilia browses the list, she won't be able to see the content of Column A in the list view. This provides an effective way to restrict access to sensitive information and maintain data privacy for specific users. As you may have noticed, we skipped the condition section during the overall demonstration. Column Permission offers a wide range of conditions, enabling you to make column control extremely flexible. We will cover them in other videos later. You can also download the user guide PDF from the description below to get detailed information about conditions. Here, let's try a simple one. Input this expression into the condition input box. With this condition, it means that column A will be hidden in the list view only if its value equals 13765. Click Save. Let's navigate back to the list. See? The content of column A is visible to Cecilia now. Another part we haven't covered in this video is the advanced settings. We provide additional features to control the capabilities of column permissions in the list. You can disable certain features, such as export to CSV or Excel, to prevent users from accessing or modifying the content of columns. By the way, all the created permission parts will work together to protect the accessibility of your columns. Okay, this is the overall introduction of the Column Permission app. You may need some time to familiar with all its features. Feel free to come back to follow the tutorial anytime you want. Thanks for watching and staying with us. Watch more. And welcome to subscribe to our channel.